Let's talk about masturbation and its brother, porn addiction. It's a brother because most men masturbate to porn. But when does watching turn into craving? When does craving become addiction? Does masturbation lead to porn addiction? What are the signs, the symptoms, the red flags? And if you've seen some of them in yourself, how do you quit? If this resonates with you, stay with me. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, board-certified urologist and specialist in sexual health. Let's start with some good news. Porn addiction is not nearly as common as many of you may think. Even if there is no official diagnosis of porn addiction, diagnostic criteria for such a behavior exist. If they are applied, most men who watch porn and masturbate wouldn't qualify for a compulsive addictive disorder. And if you now ask, but what are porn addiction signs and symptoms? There are some surprisingly straight answers to that. First, you need to qualify by time. Anything less than 6 months doesn't count. It could be just a phase and the excitement gone after 4 months. That's a formal entry criterion. But here comes the most important sign. It has to be a problem in your life. Problem means that you must think about porn constantly, that you are not able to complete a simple task without having to stop for masturbating and watching porn, that you risk your job. You watch porn while your boss is sitting next door because you can't help it, that you don't go out, that you don't see your friends, that you stopped playing your guitar because porn is pulling the strings now, that you don't have any other interests than just porn. These are red flags. The important question arises, does masturbation lead to porn addiction? Or does porn lead to masturbation addiction? Anyway, it's not easy to quit. Stopping can actually lead to withdrawal symptoms. They are similar to symptoms commonly seen in other addictive settings. There is a craving, a constant nagging that makes it impossible to concentrate on any task. You literally climb the wall. And if you can't resist, lots of guilt afterwards. I started off calling masturbation and porn addiction brothers. They feed off each other. Have you ever wondered why you masturbate at all? Some species on this planet do it, others don't. But humans are the only ones who feel guilty when they do it, because we have a conscience, we have culture and rules. But maybe there is a more universal concept behind it. One that's being crafted by nature? Science offers a fascinating explanation. What if masturbation had a meaning? What if it's an ancient program, maybe even a survival mechanism that's now overstimulated and hijacked by porn? Porn is irresistible to the brain and so hard to quit because of one key mechanism. We'll get to that in a minute. If you think this video is of value to you, please give some value in return. Watch it until the end, give it a like, and subscribe. It is a polite way of saying thank you. It's like digital applause, no money involved. Vielen Dank. So, the key player in your brain is a hormone. Well, not exactly. Where I come from, we call it neurotransmitter. But I guess hormone will do for the moment. Its name, dopamine. You might think it's about willpower, but dopamine is more powerful. The effects of porn on the brain have an immediate impact on the dopaminergic system. Porn addiction isn't just a habit, it's a cycle of dopamine release triggered by overstimulation. Every new video, every unexpected twist, every click, your brain gets another hit. Over time, your dopamine levels shift. What used to thrill you now barely moves the needle. You need more to feel less. That's how dopamine addiction works. To break the cycle, you can try a reset. It's never wrong to do that, even if scientific evidence is lacking. Many men now try a dopamine detox, not just to quit porn, but to reset their brain's reward system. Sounds familiar? A dopamine reset doesn't mean you quit everything, but it means you stop chasing novelty. You remove constant stimulation and give your brain space to feel again. Before we move on, let's recalibrate and focus on the topic of this video. Chances are you are neither addicted to porn nor masturbation. It takes a lot to fall into this category. But it never hurts to reset the mind and brain. People have done this since the beginning of time. It sharpens your thoughts and gives you a different perspective. So if you want to abstain from porn and masturbation for a while, go ahead. That's totally okay. But a word of caution, there is some danger of falling into the opposite extreme. Your way out isn't found in extremes. It's how you feel about yourself. If red flags are waving at you, sometimes professional help is the answer. Porn addiction treatment may be the answer. But if you just feel guilty, sometimes it could be a good thing to take a step back and forgive yourself. You're human. Once in a while, it helps to remember that. How to quit watching porn or overcome porn addiction? The best way is to set goals. Don't stop completely. Reduce the frequency and reward yourself when you have achieved your goal. Never plan more than 1 week ahead. Have a bailout plan for what to do when mood strikes and porn brain fog sets in. Take care. Your mental and sexual health are more connected than you think.